الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. This is Yasser Birjas from the Valley Ranch Masjid. It is summer, and one of the biggest challenges Muslims they face in the summer is the subject of lowering their gaze and protecting their sight from seeing and watching what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made unlawful for them, and it's inappropriate to see there in these public places, or even in private actually rooms and private places. In the summer, people they tend to maybe dress less because it's extremely hot for them, so they go jogging and walking and running around wearing shorts, tanks and so forth. Even people they have now that the concept of summer means entertaining, using the pools, swimming pools, going to the beaches. Even in the summer, people they tend to spend more time at night where they watch TV or go on the internet and so on, and chances that they might fall in the wrong place and falling into the wrong websites actually becomes greater and greater for both men and women. It's one of these biggest challenges. But subhanAllah, being a challenge in a time like this, it is also the most rewarding if a person maintains what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded them to maintain, to lower their gaze. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah An-Nur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nur, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُ فُرُوجَهُمْ. Say to the believing men that they should protect their sight and they should lower their gaze and protect their private parts from committing, of course, the haram and the sin. And the other ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ وَيَحْفَظْنَ فُرُوجَهُنَّ. They are also required to lower their gaze and to protect themselves from committing the sin or falling into the haram. So this is one of the major requirements in time like this. And again, it is really, really disturbing and troubling when people move around and travel around or even just drive around. They cannot just avoid that easily. And the fitna has become so great, subhanAllah, every day and after other day and so forth. So what can we do about this? The good news is that the more you hold on, the more you hold on to this commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more reward you get. Imam Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, he mentioned this issue that when the incentive to do it becomes actually not that great, and the incentive of falling into the fitna becomes so great, وَيَقِلُّ الْعَامِلُونَ, and the number of those who practice this command become less and less, that's when the reward becomes greater and greater. And one of these things now is that when you see all these now fitan around you, you become one of those few people who lower their gaze, protect their sights, and protect themselves, their hearts, and their sanity, and their iman. By following the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your reward will be immensely with Allah azza wa jal. One of the things that people they should really observe during this summer, inshaAllah, rules of modesty as much as they can. First of all, for themselves and for their household, for their families, with their brothers and sisters, with their children. So eventually try as much as possible, inshaAllah ta'ala, to teach them the rules of modesty. And one of these rules of modesty is not to look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made haram for them. We have no control over what people do outside the house because you live in a society that allows and permits these things to happen. So you have no control over this, but you have control over yourself, your family, your heart, and your eyes as well. And by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who do so bi-idhnillah will be the winners in this summer, insha'Allah ta'ala. One of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anh, Jarir ibn Abdullah, he asked the Messenger of Allah about nadrul faj'a, which means that sudden look, when you just turn your face and you see something wrong. So what do you do about it? قال اصرف بصرك, means turn your face away. Just turn your face away. In Hadith Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anh, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Ya Ali, la tutbi' al-nadrat al-nadra. Do not follow that look with another look. Which means don't just keep looking, don't keep staring. فَإِنَّ مَلَكَ الْأُولَى. The first sudden look is for you. You get reward if you take your face away from that sight. وَلَيْسَتْ لَكَ الْآخِرَةَ. But the second one will count against you. So when you see that for the first time, you take your face away, you see it, but just please lower your gaze, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for that. Yes, definitely it's gonna cause some trouble, disturbing basically your heart and your sight, and perhaps even your mind. But staying with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim, astaghfirullah al-azim, bi-idhnillah, this will protect you and protect yourself. Teach this to yourself, to your family, to your children, to the people from around you, and teach them that wherever they are, whether they're at the grocery store, in public places, or even when they're at home, teach them that, and inshallah ta'ala, in the summer, bi'inillah, Allah shall reward you to maintain that rule of modesty. And the best thing, inshallah, you could do in the summer again, to teach yourself to prepare for the coming of the month of Ramadan, preparing from now. And hopefully, inshallah, this will be a reason for your iman to increase and becomes easier for you to maintain that rule of modesty and lowering the gaze. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.